time, I call this meeting to order. This is a public hearing on the setting of the millage rate for Lowndes County. If you would, I'm gonna go ahead and turn the meeting over to Ms. Stephanie Black, Lowndes County Finance Director, and she will give us a presentation. Ms. Black?
Yes, sir, thank you. This is the third public hearing for the millage. You'll see on the screen there, the dates were September 19th and 26th. There were two on the 19th. The third was scheduled for the 26th, had to be rescheduled due to the hurricane, so that is today. This is the third hearing on the millage, and the adoption will be at the 5:30 meeting. So first of all, what is millage? Millage is the tax levied by the county for county purposes. It's the tax rate per $1,000 of assessed property value, and you determine it by dividing your budgeted tax revenues by your total digest, which is the value of all property in the county, and subtracting any rollbacks. Under the Taxpayer Bill of Rights, that requires that you roll back the millage if there's significant net value added reassessment. So if you have that reassessed value, you have to calculate the millage equivalent of that and subtract it from your prior millage rate, and that would apply to all existing real property. There's a state mandated formula which computes the tax revenue increase from that reassessment as a percentage. If you don't roll it back to that computed millage rate, you have to advertise the tax increase as a percentage, and you have to have three public hearings before you can set the millage. So just as an example, if you had $100 million from reassessment and your digest was $2 billion and your prior year millage rate was 8.778, the millage equivalent of that $100 million is 0.439 mils. So your rollback millage would be the difference in those two, or 8.339 mils. If you set your millage rate at 8.778, which is exactly what it was the prior year, you would have to advertise a tax increase of 5%. In order to not advertise that, you would have to set it at 8.339. So under the actual rollback calculation, the value added from reassessment was $829 million. And your current year digest is $5.1 billion. Your prior year millage was 8.778. The millage equivalent of that $829 million is 1.422 mils. So your rollback millage would be 7.356. If you elected to leave it at 8.778, you would have had to advertise a 19.33% tax increase. What was advertised was 7.804, which was a 6.09% tax increase. But because there is an increase based on that calculation, you still have to have the three public hearings before you can set the millage. The formulas that you use to calculate millage, first you have your gross millage, which is your budgeted property tax. And that is made up of the county tax, the industrial authority tax, and the recreation authority tax, and your budgeted local option sales tax, and you divide that by your total digest. Then your lost rollback, or your local option sales tax, is your budgeted local option sales tax divided by your digest, and then the difference in those two is your net millage. Just as a reminder about local option sales tax, in Lowndes County, the sales tax rate is 8%. So for every 8 cents on the dollar that you pay, 4 cents of that goes to the state of Georgia. 1 cent of that is for the transportation SPLOST, and that is a regional tax, so that is split between the counties in, or the cities and counties in that region, and that's for transportation improvement projects. Then you have 1 cent that goes towards SPLOST, that is split between the county and the cities and is used for capital improvement, and those are voted on. You have your education SPLOST, which is split between the school systems for capital improvements. Again, those have to be voted on. And then your local option sales tax, which is 1 cent, and that is split between the county and the cities, and that has to be used for property tax relief. That reduces the amount of property tax that you have to raise during the year. The millage calculation, you have the prior year in here as a comparison. And what you'll see at the very bottom is a 96% collection rate. That is what we use to budget by, because we normally collect between 95 and 96% of assessed taxes in any year. The first, or the middle column is what was advertised. And you'll see that that was its, the net millage was 7.804 compared to 8.778. That includes the industrial authority and the recreation authority. And at a 96% collection rate, that would be $38.3 million total, with $28.4 million at 100% come into the county. And there's also an option one there, that is if you set the millage at the rollback millage. At the unincorporated fire millage, beginning in 2021, there was an unincorporated fire millage added to pay for expansion of fire services. That has been set at 2.5 mils each year since, and the proposal is to remain at 2.5 mils. So as an example, and this is a little bit confusing compared to prior years, because last year there was an extra exemption given by the governor's office. But the first column is at 7.804 mils, and that is the county and the recreation and the industrial. But this also includes the calculation for the school board and the cities as well, if those are included. This, the first example here is for an unincorporated home at $200,000. At the advertised rate, the estimated tax, including the county schools, is an increase of $355, but that's because $464 was paid by the governor's office last year. At 7.356, which would be the rollback millage, that increase would be $322, but again, that's because $464 was paid by the governor last year. For someone inside the city limits of Valdosta on that same property, at the advertised rate, that increase is $431. Again, that includes the city of Valdosta and the city school board. But 536 was paid by the governor last year. At the rollback millage, that would still be an increase of $398. If you break down for every dollar that you pay, if you're in the unincorporated area, 23 cents of that comes to Lowndes County. 5 cents goes to the recreation authority. 4 cents goes to the industrial authority. 58 cents goes to the school board, and 10 cents goes to the fire department. If you're inside the city limits of Valdosta, for every dollar that you pay, 20 cents comes to Lowndes County, 4 cents to the recreation authority, 4 cents to the industrial authority, 23 cents to the city of Valdosta, and 50 cents to the city school board. If you look at the millage history, the dark purple bar is the amount that actually comes to the county, and you will see where that has decreased every year since 2017. The very last column is put in, or the last column is put in there as an example, just the comparison of the 7.356 compared to the 7.804. And then where does your money go? This breaks down the county budget. For every dollar that you spend, Board of Commissioners and administration, which would include things like the county clerk, county manager, community development, public information, finance, HR, ITS, 9 cents of every dollar goes towards that. 1 cent goes to the Board of Elections, 2 cents to the tax commissioner, 3 cents to the Board of Assessors, 2 cents for engineering, 1 cent for contingency. All of your court services, 12 cents. The sheriff's office, 36 cents. Animal services, 2 cents. Emergency medical services, 2 cents. All other public safety, 5 cents. Public works, 11 cents. The industrial authority, 5 cents. The recreation authority, 6 cents. And all others, 3 cents.
Any questions? Any block again on the presentation, thank you. Very efficient as always. This is a public hearing, so in just a few minutes, I'm going to open up the meeting as a public hearing. But I first want to say, before we advertised an increase in the millage, went through that process. But I can tell you, after discussion with the commissioners, we have no intent at this time to increase the taxes. We intend to use the rollback method. But since we advertised and went that way, we did that because we're in some unprecedented times right now, simply because of the storms that we had, not knowing exactly what those expenses and how they were going to be incurred and how we were going to handle them. We've gotten a little further into that process now. We've got a better handle on how we can manage through that process. And so we're confident at this point that we will be able to get through it with the revenue that will be presented by using the rollback millage rate. So that's what our intent is. But we will go ahead and go through the public hearing process and give those an opportunity that would like to speak for the advertised increase or against the advertised increase. So with that, I'll go ahead and open up the meeting. It's a public hearing, so is there anyone in the audience